My portfolio is currently up over 100% in the last year to a current value of over $250,000. And if you've watched my channel for a while, you've been able to see exactly which stocks I've invested in to achieve those gains. So in this video, I'm going to walk through exactly which stocks are in each of my investment accounts, show you how much money is invested in each of those stocks, and explain why I picked those stocks to invest in. At the end of the video, I will also talk about any trades that I made in the past month, including two companies which I have not talked about in my reviews before, as well as two stocks that I sold out of completely. This was probably my most active trading month ever, so make sure you watch until the end. But let's not waste too much time, and let's pull up my brokerage account and start going through my individual stocks. So I have pulled up here my Charles Schwab account, which I like to use for these reviews because it combines all the different stock portfolios that I have into one view. Now, as you can see here, my stock portfolio for the year is up around 117% over the past year. But during that time, it hasn't all been smooth sailing. You can see that from November 2020 last year, the stock portfolio rose pretty consistently up until March or late February 2021, after which it had a crazy crash in the stock price, at the peak being down almost $30,000 from the high point. But I decided to stay invested in the market, and the market kept on going up until around May 2021, when again it crashed back down to where it was at the minimum again, before pretty much steadily rising throughout the rest of the year up until October, to a new high of $238,000. Then over the course of about 3 days, my portfolio lost around $20,000 all at once. Now, when you see this happen in your portfolio, it's easy to panic and try to sell out completely, but I stayed invested and my portfolio has since recovered to a new high of around $270,000 in total. And if we want to look in more detail at what just happened in the past month, my portfolio is basically flat over the past month. It rose to an all-time high in around November 9th of $288,000, but since then it's given up a couple of those gains, mostly due to one stock in my portfolio, which I will talk about, to its current level of $270,000. But now let's move on to looking at the actual individual stocks in this account. And we're gonna go in order of decreasing size. So the first position and the largest position that I own is Datadog, which I own 444 shares of at a market value of nearly $85,000. And that's off a cost basis of just over $37,000. So in total, I've made almost $48,000 on just this one stock. That's well over a 100% rate of return. Datadog allows companies to take their security, their infrastructure, and their applications and view all the data that those are producing in a single pane of glass, allowing them to run their business much more efficiently and actually take actionable insights on that data. This company has a much lower price to sales ratio than almost any other stock on this list, and yet it's been growing consistently at a much higher rate than most of these other companies as well. Plus, as we see more and more companies move into the cloud and produce more and more data over time, this company is set up perfectly to benefit from that, which is why this is by far my highest conviction position. And by the way, if you appreciate this full transparency in my stock portfolio, please just hit the like button. I do these reviews because I want to be transparent, and I think that some people can learn from it. Next up, we have CrowdStrike, which I have 238 shares of at a value of $64,000, which is again off a basis of $30,000 and an increase of nearly $34,000, another 100% return. CrowdStrike is the best security company in the world, and their cloud native architecture is allowing them to beat pretty much every other company out there in gaining new cloud security clients. This company has grown consistently at over 70% per year, again has a lower price to sales ratio than a lot of the other companies on this list, and it is benefiting from the secular move to the cloud and all the infrastructure that needs to be secured there. But moving on to my third largest position, we have Cloudflare, which I have 257 shares of at a value of $55,000. And this is off an initial investment of only $17,000. So this position has more than tripled by $38,000. And one thing you might notice here is that all these companies here have ratings of D's or C's, and some of them even have F ratings. Now, the entire time that I have owned Cloudflare, I think it's had at best a C rating and at worst an F rating. And yet, as you can see here, it's returned over 200%. So in my opinion, listening to these kinds of ratings is completely useless and in some cases probably hurts your gains overall. What Cloudflare does is make the internet itself work better. They started out as a CDN service, offering firewall services to protect websites, but then they realized that they could analyze internet traffic to block bad actors, but then optimize the experience for good actors. This company is probably the most rock solid grower that I've ever seen, pretty much growing at 50% per year since 2016. The only reason this isn't my largest position is because the price has gone up substantially recently. In fact, its price to sales ratio crossed 100 in the past month. Now, I have actually sold some of the shares that I used to own in this position, but it's just grown so quickly that it's maintained the same market value as I had a month ago. At this point, I'm probably not gonna sell any more shares and just let this company run, because it's really trying to become the next Amazon at this point. Now, these three largest positions are basically the same as I had last month, but as we move into my fourth position, we start to see some changes. My fourth largest position now is a company called Zscaler, which I own 60 shares of at a value of $22,000, and it's made around $5,500 off a $16,500 investment. Zscaler is also in the security space, but they provide zero trust access. So in traditional models, you would have, let's say, your company, and you would have one network around your company, and bad actors had to stay outside. But if they ever broke through their network, they had pretty much free rein to access anything. With zero trust, the idea is that actors are already inside your network and you have to authenticate every single thing that they touch. This is the new way that security is going to work going forward, and this company has obviously benefited from that. And full transparency, as I'm going through this list, this does not include my entire investment portfolio. These are only the individual stocks that I own. I also have a 401k where I just invest passively into index funds, and even though I invest more money into that account, it's actually worth less than this account because these stocks have outperformed the market so dramatically. After Zscaler, we have Zoom Info at 168 shares at a value of $13,000, and it's made around $3,000 off of a $10,000 initial investment, so about 30%. Zoom Info I've only owned for a few months, but what they do is make it easy for salespeople to connect with the people and companies that they need to be selling to. This is a win for the salespeople because they don't have to waste their time knocking on doors, and it's a win for the people and the companies who actually want to use the products that the salespeople are reaching out for, rather than just contacting people who aren't interested. Zoom Info has continued to grow very steadily throughout the year, and I have no plans on changing my allocation to it at this point. But next up, we have Upstart, which I own 53 shares of at a value of $12,000, and it's actually lost $6,000 off of an initial $18,000 investment. Now, that number is actually a little bit misleading, but let me first tell you about the company. Upstart creates risk models for giving out personal loans using AI. So a traditional loan model just looks at one number, a person's FICO score, and uses that to determine if they're worthy of a loan or not. Upstart gets rid of that one number and replaces it with thousands of different parameters that they then feed into an AI model, allowing them to offer loans to people that normally wouldn't qualify or to offer lower rates to well-qualified people. Now, up until this past quarter, Upstart was growing at 60% quarter over quarter. But after reporting their latest earnings, that growth rate dropped substantially. And so with that, the stock dropped around 40%. Now, luckily, when I saw their earnings report, I realized that their growth was slowing dramatically, so I sold around 2/3 of my total position, and then a few days after that, the stock was down an additional 8%. So by selling out quickly and not looking back, I was able to reduce the effect of this drop overall, and people who are on my Patreon were able to see me do that in near real time. Now, I do still believe in Upstart going forward in the long term, but they're not a software as a service company, so they're gonna have some lumpiness in their growth as they go. And so for now, I'm going to keep this as the same size, but I may add a little bit more to this company over the next month. Next up, we have C Limited, which I own 23 shares of at a value of $7,000. It's made around $1,600 off an initial investment of $5,500. C Limited is kind of like the Amazon of Southeast Asia. They have three businesses rolled into one: Garena, their video game business; Shopee, their e-commerce business; and C Money, which is their digital financing business. C Limited is growing very quickly, and the only reason this isn't a larger position is because they're so heavily into the e-commerce space, and that is a brutally difficult market to get into with competitors like Alibaba and Amazon. That being said, C Limited has done extremely well so far capturing the Southeast Asian market as well as Brazil, and they're moving into other countries too, such as Mexico. So this is a company to watch very closely. There's also a potential metaverse play with this company, which could be interesting in the next few months. After that, we have SoFi with 119 shares and at a value of $2,500. So it's basically flat from the initial initial amount that I put into the company. And part of that is because I added more to the stock after their recent run-up. SoFi plans to be the winner in what they see as the winner takes most market of fintechs. The company reported pretty solid earnings recently, and they don't really have any huge negatives facing them in the short term, but they do have positive catalysts such as possibly obtaining a bank charter soon, which could cause the stock price to rise relatively quickly. The only reason this isn't a larger position for me is because the price seems to be driven a lot by investor sentiment rather than by the actual numbers. So even though I do think it's a good company that will outperform in the long term, in the short term, it's a little bit risky because it doesn't operate in quite the same way as the other companies that I own. And then last up, we have Affirm, which I own 14 shares of at a value of $2,000, and it's lost about $71 off of the initial investment, so basically flat. Affirm operates in the buy now, pay later space. So what they'll do is they'll add a way that you can check out on different websites like Shopify, where rather than paying right away, you can instead break up that payment into monthly payments over time. Now, Affirm obviously has a large market and they're growing very quickly, and they say that they benefit consumers by letting them use Affirm's buy now, pay later rather than high interest credit cards. At the same time, 45% of people who use buy now, pay later say they do it because they can't afford something, and 20% do it because they already maxed out their credit cards. So from a business model perspective, this company makes a lot of sense to invest in, but the fact that they have kind of a disconnect between their stated mission statement and what they're actually doing is the reason that this is only the smallest position in my portfolio. I'm basically holding on to it until their next earnings report when I can get a better picture of if management is being truthful or not. And if we go up, you'll also notice that some of these stocks had a 2 next to them. And that's because I hold these positions both in Charles Schwab as well as in my Vanguard Roth IRA account. Now, a Roth IRA allows you to invest up to $6,000 into the market every year, and you don't ever have to pay taxes on the gains that you get in there. So for example, with these top three largest positions where I've made over 100% returns, I never have to pay taxes on those in my Roth IRA account, which is why I always try to max that out every year. Now, I also said I would let you know what trades I made in this portfolio in the past month. So let's go over those real quick. Now, I already talked about Upstart, which I sold 2/3 of my position of based on their earnings, but I redeployed that money primarily into Datadog and CrowdStrike. The reason for that is these companies are rock solid growers and they have a much lower price to sales ratio than, say, Cloudflare does. The other trades that I made this month included completely selling out of one stock that I own called Global E. Global E was a company that made it easier for e-commerce customers to buy stuff over international borders. They had big partners like Shopify and they were doing really well, but after their latest earnings report, their growth slowed dramatically, so I sold out of that company and put all the money into Datadog. One other stock that is no longer in my portfolio, which was for a while, is Snowflake. Snowflake is a company that offers an order of magnitude less complexity with companies dealing with their data. Now, Snowflake, I think, is a very good company that's growing extremely quickly, but they had a very high price to sales ratio and they were starting to get a little more complicated with how they're presenting their financials. And so I just didn't feel like I could keep track of that company while following all these other stocks. So I sold out of it completely. At this point, I just hold these 9 stocks in my portfolio and I have much higher conviction in these positions than the ones that I sold out of. And so I'm much better able to tell when these companies' thesis changes and either buy more or sell out. Now, if you would like any more information on when I'm making these trades, I do have a Patreon where I update in near real time when I buy or sell stocks. Now, I don't want to make like a hard push for this or anything. I'm still going to update all my trades on here. But if you just like that information a little bit sooner, you can sign up for my Patreon using the link in the description. But let me know what your favorite stocks are right now. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.